Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen is in China to discuss global concerns over the country's excess manufacturing capacity. Yellen, who arrived in Guangzhou Thursday, will be meeting with Premier Li Qiang, as well as other government officials. Her visit is focused on discussing China's overproduction of electric vehicles, semiconductors, and other goods. Yellen told commerce officials in Guangzhou China's intensified production is pressuring other economies and hurting producers in other countries. She called on China to curb its production capacity and potentially cooperate with Washington to sustainably attain Beijing's growth targets.
I believe addressing overcapacity and, more generally, considering market-based reforms is in China's interest. As I've said before, China is too large to export its way to rapid growth. And if policies are oriented only at generating supply and not also at generating demand, global spillovers will result.
Philippine economic growth came in lower than initially reported in 2023. The Statistics Authority revised lower to 5.5% from 5.6% last year's full-year GDP. It said this move is based on an approved revision policy that's consistent with international standards. This comes on the heels of Manila's economic managers lowering GDP growth targets for this year and the next. Let's check on European markets first. They're sliding to a more than two-week low, with travel and leisure stocks leading declines. It says global oil prices jump amid concerns over supply disruption following the escalating tensions in the Middle East. As for Wall Street, they're pointing to a rebound for the major U.S. indices after they saw sharp falls overnight. In focus today, the all-important jobs data, which will give insights on the health of the U.S. labor market and the timing of the rate cuts. Economists polled by Reuters anticipate a rise of 200,000 jobs compared with 275,000 in February, while the unemployment rate will likely remain steady at 3.9%.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Stellantis after it was reported the company's production output in its Italian plants fell by 10% in the first quarter. Stellantis shares dropped 2% on the news. Also in focus, shares of Delivery Hero after an activist investor built a 3% stake in the company delivery business and may be seeking to oust its CEO. Delivery Hero shares plunged 3% in midday trading. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Apple, which confirmed it is laying off over 600 employees in its first significant job cut since the pandemic. Apple shares are slightly up before the bell.